came to the sepulchre.
And when they get to the sepulchre,
so they ran both together.
They run.
And the other disciple did outrun Peter.
And the other one outran Peter.
And came first to the sepulchre.
And when they get to the tomb,
and he stooping down,
he stooped down,
and looking in,
and looked in,
saw the linen clothes
and
lying.
He saw the clothes that were on the body of Jesus
lying.
Laying there.
Yet went he not in.
But he didn't go in.
Then cometh Simon Peter.
I wouldn't have went in either.
Amen.
So he ain't go in.
Then cometh Simon Peter.
But he went Peter.
Following him.
Peter came.
And went into the sepulchre.
Peter went in. Peter said, wait a minute. I know where they laid him. And he's not here. Now remember, it is so early on the first day of the week to the point that it's still dark.
Amen.
The sun is just getting ready to break through. So this means now that Jesus got up before Mary ever got there.
Amen.
That's right.
That's right.
He's already risen.
Amen.
So we can't even classify the first day of the week morning as a day.
Amen.
Because when she got there, he was gone.
He's gone.
So in order for him to be gone at the beginning of that first day of the week, while it was early and it was still dark, means he had to fulfill those 3 days and those 3 nights in the earth.
Amen.
Which now makes us have to go into what day he died.
That's right.
Amen.
All right, so there's a bunch of arguments about the day. Was it a Thursday? Was it a Wednesday? Well, we're going to do our best mathematical equation tonight to see how we can get a full 3 days and a full 3 nights without making Jesus a liar.
Amen.
A minister Blair, it don't matter. All that matters is that he got up. Wait a minute.
That's right.
It does matter.
Yes,
because
it does.
If you don't get 3 days,
that's
and you
right.
don't get 3 nights, you make Jesus a liar.
Yes, amen. It does matter.
Amen.
And yes,
it does. You know why? Because the Bible said no lie is of the truth.
Yeah.
And the Bible said every liar gonna have his part in the lake of fire, which burn him with fire and brimstone. And you don't want to make God out of a liar, and you don't want to be a liar.
Amen.
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 You don't want to teach people something that is not true, not factual, because you'll be found a liar.
Amen.
So we're not here to condemn them tonight, we're here to help them.
Amen.
In order that they may have it right with the word of God. Luke 24, 46. We're going to show you why these things have to be fulfilled. Got to be fulfilled.
Amen.
Luke 24, 46 says what?
And said unto them.
He said unto them.
Thus it is written.
Thus it is written.
And thus it behooved Christ.
And thus it behooved Christ.
To suffer.
To suffer.
And to rise from the dead.
And to rise from the dead.
The third day.
Uh-oh. The third day. Not only do we have him being in the heart of the earth for the 3 days and for the 3 nights, but we have him actually resurrecting on that third day.
Amen.
All these details make a difference.
Amen.
He's not going to rise on the fourth day morning.
That's right.
He's going to rise on that third day. He's going to stay in there until 3 days is complete. And the minute the 3 days are over, he's getting up out of that grave.
Amen.
Because he got to get up on the third day. Even though he's going to stay in there 3 days, on that third day, after he has gotten to that last second of that third day, he's getting up out of that grave.
Amen.
Because if he would have stayed in there any second longer on the fourth day, the king sits in. But the Bible said he will not leave my soul in hell.
Amen.
He will only suffer his holy one to see corruption. So before corruption could sit in, God had to raise the body.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So now,
amen.
Let's do some math. Jesus was crucified roughly around 3 p.m. And we got to trail his body until he gets to the tomb. So we're going to save it about 5, 6, because their preparation is coming, and they got to put the bodies in the ground, got to take them off the cross. So we got to calculate and consider that the first day of the week, which is Sunday, early in the morning while it was yet still dark, Mary goes and he's gone. So let's calculate. Wednesday at 3 p.m., Jesus has been crucified. They take him off the cross, put him in the ground about 5, 6-ish, and now he's actually buried. Wednesday, since it's only 12 hours in a day, would mean that he's entered into the tomb Wednesday night.
Uh-huh.
And so from Wednesday night into Thursday sunrise, calculating
one night,
those 12 hours, while it is dark outside, this would be considered the first night.
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 Because it's dark.
Amen. Because darkness is night.
The light time is day.
Amen.
So because it's dark, this is the first night. So the first day would be Thursday sunrise until Thursday sunset.
Amen.
Amen.
Because it's only 12 hours.
In a day.
In a day.
Amen.
So with the Thursday sunrise and sunset consisting of the first day, now Thursday sunset until Friday sunrise will make it night number two.
Amen.
And then Friday sunrise to Friday sunset will make it day number two.
That's right. Amen.
See, y'all got messed up because you got your nights coming before your days. Because it goes off of the way he was crucified. Right.
Amen, amen.
He was crucified at 3 p.m., buried around 6. So you can't count Wednesday as a day.
That's right.
So his first night took place on Wednesday into Thursday.
Amen.
So on Friday, sunrise to Friday sunset would have been day two. So how do you have him being crucified on a day in which he was already in the grave?
Amen.
Amen.
For the second day.
That's right.
All right, y'all ready?
Amen.
So the third night would be from Friday sunset till Saturday sunrise. That's the third night.
Right.
So you got three nights completed.
That's right.
Amen.
You got three nights completed. So now you got to get the third day. But not only do you got to get the third day, you got to get him rising on that third day.
Yeah.
Not the fourth day. You got to get him rising that third day. All right. So the third day would be Saturday sunrise to Saturday sunset.
Uh-huh.
And the minute the sun set on Saturday, which would have made him get ready to enter into the night, entering into the first day of the week, when she went there, he was gone.
Right.
Uh-huh, uh-huh, uh-huh.
Because he rose on that third day.
Right.
Which means he got out of that grave at sunset on Saturday.
Uh-huh.
That when Mary went up to the tomb on early Sunday morning while it was still dark, he was gone.
He was gone.
Let the church say
amen.
Amen. Amen.
Wow.
So you can't have a Friday crucifixion and a Sunday morning resurrection.
Right.
And you can't have a Thursday crucifixion
right.
and a Sunday morning resurrection, because you'll start running in and cutting days short
yep.
and cutting nights short. You've got to get full 3 days
3 nights.
And full 3 nights.
Amen.
So Jesus was crucified on a Wednesday around 3 p.m. He was laid in that tomb around 6 p.m. on Wednesday night. And when his body went into that tomb, it began the counting process.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
So we got him going in the grave at Wednesday, 6 p.m. And we got him coming out of the grave that third day, which was sunset on Saturday.
Amen.
Sunset. Amen.
Right before the sun rose.
Amen.
On Sunday morning. Because when Mary went to the tomb,
he was gone.
It was still dark.
That's right.
It was that early. If she would have went midday Sunday and found the body was gone, then we could have an argument.
Amen.
That maybe he got up when the sun rose Sunday morning. But because scripture reveals that she went there early enough to the point where it was still dark and the body was gone, he had to have gotten up at the close of Saturday.
Amen.
Amen.
That's right.
Which will fulfill 3 days,
yep,
3 nights, and it will get him rising on the third day.
Amen.
Mm.
I got it?
Amen.
So that's why we're not getting ready to go around here and carry on Friday night.
Only Thursday.
Talk about some good Friday. Because it's impossible to stay in biblical context, stay with what Bible reveals, and get 3 days and 3 nights out of a Friday crucifixion and a Sunday morning resurrection. Especially keeping with the teaching of Jesus, it's only 12 hours in a day.
Amen. Right. Amen.
The light is day, and the darkness is night.
Mm-hmm.
Keeping with the teaching of Jesus Christ, through his own omission and his own prophetic utterance, we have a Wednesday crucifixion, a Wednesday night burial.
Amen.
And a Saturday at sunset resurrection.
Mm.
Amen.
That's the only way we can get 3 days.
Amen.
And 3 nights. So y'all just learned something that you can go tell your co-workers.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
So they can
Amen.
Come on out of their falsehood.
That's right.
Amen.
And stop doing 7 last words, sayings of Jesus.
Yes.
My God.
It's a Friday night. And you can stop sitting here talking about Easter Sunday.
Amen. Right.
Amen. Mm.
Because before that light even came up, Jesus was already up
already
out of that
grave.
Amen. Amen.
He was already out of the grave.
Already
out. Already out of the grave. Before the sun came up on the first day of the week, he was already out of the grave.
Right.
All right? And even though we like the little colors, and you know, everybody gonna come in with a little pastel color on.
Yeah. Right.
Folks just like the colors.
Uh-huh.
I don't want nobody twisted and mistaken that we think.
Amen.
That Jesus got up on Easter Sunday. It's impossible when it comes to the Word of God.
Lord Jesus.
And you keep everything within its proper context.
Amen.
Aren't y'all glad for knowledge tonight, my
Amen.
People?
Amen.
For the lack of knowledge.
That's right.
All thy getting, get
understanding. Amen.
And you get it for yourself. Not so you can say, I know more than you.
Amen.
Uh-huh.
But you get it so you know it for yourself.
That's right.
That's right.
Because you don't want to be found alive.
Amen.
Walk around telling people that Jesus was crucified on a Friday.
Amen.
And he rose on a Sunday. If we teach that, we teach a lie.
Amen.
And contradict what Jesus reveals in the Word. Put your hands together.
Amen.
Amen.
For the lesson on tonight.
Amen.
Thank God for what his Word reveals to us. And if we study his Word, we'll have a clearer understanding of what we believe, why we believe it, and why we do what we do.
Amen.
I want to get into a teaching on Passover.
Amen.
And I want to talk about Passover because Christ is our Passover.
Amen.
And I'm going to show you how Passover and what they do during Passover will end up being why we have transitioned to do communion the way that we do it.
Amen, amen, amen.
Paul said what he said, and what Paul was mirroring in 1 Corinthians 11 chapter, what he was mirroring when he was teaching the church concerning communion, it was stemming from what transpired during Passover.
Amen.
All right?
Amen.
And so because he is our Passover lamb, he is our Passover sacrifice. We're going to get into the Passover, and y'all will see more clearly why we have transitioned from partaking in the body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ in the traditional setting that we're used to doing, and why we have transitioned into the setting that we now do it in.
Amen. All right? Amen.
All right, so put your minds and hearts together and prepare your minds for study so we can get into that. Amen. So we have a clearer understanding of why we're no longer standing in the front of the church.
Amen.
Taking communion like we've traditionally done it for so long. All right?
Amen.
Amen. So we thank God for His truth. Amen. We thank God for His word.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name. Peace be unto you.
Amen. In Jesus' name.